Hey friends, creating visuals usually means you have to learn new software, and sometimes multiple programs, and this can be time-consuming and frustrating. I'm stoked to show you VideoSync, a nice set of tools that allow you to make really interesting high-tech visuals and video edits using Ableton Live's interface and automation system. VideoSync simply uses the logic and skills that you might already have in Ableton Live and allows you to apply them to visual creation. In this video, we're going to check out VideoSync and how you can take advantage of its awesome capabilities. Let's do it. Okay, so check out this audio-visual experience that I've made here with just Ableton Live empowered by VideoSync. Now, I know that this is a lot, right? There's a lot going on here. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go ahead and get rid of most of what's happening here so we can actually take a look. And check this out. I'm actually removing elements of this video by simply muting tracks. And that's one of the first things that I want to point your attention to with the VideoSync system. It simply utilizes Ableton Live's built-in system, right? So for example, I'm looking at this first layer here. This second track here is the first visual layer. Check this out. I can turn it down, and wow, it changes the opacity, right? So it's just a simple logic. It's like, okay, I want to turn this down. I need to crank this down. I'm just changing the opacity of the visuals by turning the track down, right? Super cool. So what I'm using here is actually an instrument inside of VideoSync. VideoSync comes with many devices and instruments, and one of them is called Tabula, and this one's super cool because essentially what it does is it allows you to take notes, MIDI notes, and actually create visuals using those notes by stratifying those notes across a visual field and changing the colors of them, for example. So go ahead and check this out. Right, super cool. So the notes that I actually played in this drift track, I decided to copy the MIDI and put it over here. So utilizing the skills that I already have in Ableton, something that I could do maybe is do some volume fades right here. So maybe I'll just make a little volume fade and then I can duplicate it a bunch of times. So not only will this be fading the opacity of those keys, but it's also to the beat. I'll go ahead and add the beat back in, check it out. So this is stuff that you already know, and that's what's the advantage of VideoSync. It's stuff that you already know how to do, okay? Another thing that you already know how to do is, of course, automation. So again, looking at the softness of these keys, right, I went ahead and did something interesting. I'm going to go ahead and redo it so you can watch the process, but I'm going to go ahead and delete this automation, and so now we just have a specific softness the whole time, right? But instead, what I can do is I can go into this track, and I think I used a bandpass filter to change the filtration of these keys. And so what I can do is I can actually copy that automation, right? I can copy it, and then I can apply it to the softness. So now the same curves that will edit the filtration of these keys will now also edit the softness of the keys. And so you get this unity between visual and audio content. And maybe I want this to be a little more extreme, or I want some aspect of it to change, but I still want them to be interrelated. Well, all I have to do is select this area right here, and maybe I can crank it up a bit. Right? So they're still related. So this first element I've broken out into separate tracks, but you don't have to do that. Let's go ahead and take a look at the second layer. So, now this track contains the visual and the audio elements all in one instrument rack, right? So on this one I have Arteria Pigments playing the lead voice, and then in this track I have my VideoSync devices, okay? So in this one I'm using this one called Squares. Let's go ahead and kind of break this one down real quick so you can see what's possible. So first of all, I'll mute the first visual. So what I'm doing is I'm just using another interpretive device from VideoSync. It's called Squares. And essentially, you can just set out a note range and it'll show you those notes on the screen just in a different way than the first one did. But what I used to affect this was my favorite effect in any visual environment. And I just love feedback. I've always liked feedback. So check it out. When I turn this on, not only is it making what you could consider to be visual delay, right? Just like audio has delay, but it also can rotate that delay as it feeds back through the system, creating these interesting fractal trees. So check this out. Super cool, right? Now, of course, I used a couple other devices to make it look nicer. So I colorized it, added a color utility to kind of make it bright. Now you might be seeing this breathing and you're like, what on earth is happening there? Well, the next thing to understand is that VideoSync utilizes a layer system just like, you know, Photoshop or any of the other visual programs that you might have used. And so what's happening is that you could think of it as this being the lowest layer all the way up to the highest layer. And then on the main track, I've got my finalization effects. You could consider these as finalization. So one thing that I'm doing, I'm using a little bit of blurring here to kind of make this look a little bit nicer and to get rid of some of those ugly feedback things that can happen. And then in the next one, I'm using this color mixer. And what I'm doing is I'm actually using an LFO that's synced to the clock. Yet again, it's synced to a half bar. And what it's doing is it's sort of making it breathe to the beat. So check it out. Let's add the beat back in. Hey, by the way, the kind folks at VideoSync are offering 40% off to folks who join my Ableton online courses. My courses are thorough and optimized with over 120 hours of video lessons, just like this video. And so if you take your music, your education, and your career seriously, you can check that out via the link up here or down in the description. All right, let's get back to it. Right, so this layered system is really interesting. Another thing that I'm doing here is there's this track right here, and this track actually has some volume automation here. Essentially, you can see that it's adding some of this glitchy noise. I want to show you something else. When it comes to layers, you also can change the blending mode of those layers, just like you can in Photoshop or whatever other program you use, or Premiere or something. You can simply choose different styles of blend modes, and they will interact with your layers in interesting ways. And so this one, I put it on overlay mode. It'll kind of choke out some of the visuals as it gets real bright, but check it out, I also have volume automation. So we're looking at when it's really high. When it's really low, you can see that it has barely any effect at all. I'll go ahead and turn down the breathing effect real quick so we can really watch this. So check it out. It's getting glitchier. Super cool. So I'm going to go ahead and move the visuals over to this side, and I want to show you something else. VideoSync lives in your user library when you install it, but what it comes with is effects and instruments. And so I've already showed you Tabula and Squares. There's some other really interesting things, such as a VideoSimpler, and this allows you to put a bunch of different video clips inside of a simpler, and you can play them with your keys. Super awesome. But what I want to show you here is another really awesome device, and that's the ISF shader. And so what this allows you to do is to import shaders into Ableton. And one of the shaders that I'm using right now is the one for the drums. And so essentially what a shader is it could be anything from a filter to a transition to a generator of visuals that you can download from the internet. There are so many shaders out there. So you can infinitely expand VideoSync to do all kinds of crazy stuff. And so right now I'm using this one called Hoop Dreams. And each one of these shaders come with all of these different parameters. You can even get down to the code level and edit these if you like. But for now, I'm just showing you that I'm using the modulation system in Ableton to kind of mess with the zoom here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and mute these first visuals here, and we're just going to watch the drums go. So not only is this visual bouncing up and down because I'm automating zoom, but it's also rotating, you can see, at subdivisions of a quarter note, right? So how cool is that? It's just rotating, bop, 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 right? Now, another thing I want to show you is that I'm using an envelope follower to change the zoom. So right now, the gain of the zoom is really high. So if I turn this all the way down, no zoom, right? But as I turn it up, we can get real close. Super fun, right? So you can use an envelope follower to edit the visuals that you're using. And so, yeah, VideoSync is super integrated into the way that you already know how to use Ableton. And that's what's so powerful about it. I could use envelope follower and send it all over this entire composition, right? Super awesome. So, you know, the last layer is just this bass that pulses. Yet again, using an envelope follower and a shader called Black Hole. Just for the heck of it, let's look at some of these other shaders. So I'll just choose some random ones. So inner dimensions. So let me show you how you would do this. Like essentially you would find a parameter that you think is interesting and notice how it keeps the mappings, even though I don't have this one specifically mapped. I could simply try some aspect of this, for example, dry wet. So dry wet turns this visual up or down. So what I could do is I could simply go to my envelope, choose to map that to dry wet, and now, I'll set it about halfway and then I'll go to the gain here and check this out. Love it. All right, let's look at a different example. So check this out. What I wanted to show you here is that you can actually use video as well inside of VideoSync. So for example, what I'm doing here is I'm just using a meld drone that I made, but I'm using it to sort of edit these visuals here. So let me go ahead and show you what this looks like without any of these effects on it from VideoSync. And I'll take you through my method here. And so the first effect I used was called transform. And so when I initially imported this footage, I wanted to do a vertical format video. So in order to do that, I used transform and I rotated it 90 degrees to make it fit, right? The next thing I did is I used mirror so I could kind of focus on the sun here, peeking through the tree branches, right? And then the next thing I used was colorize. And so instead of using these natural colors that I had, I wanted to make it look all wild and crazy. Then I used color utility and I shifted the hue a little bit. And you can see that what's going on here is that it is breathing in and out using saturation. So you can see saturation moving up and down, yet again, taking advantage of an LFO that I have actually sitting on this track. Now this LFO is not only affecting the visuals, but there's also mappings on this LFO to various audio parameters. And so this is what's so interesting about this. Essentially, this LFO is breathing up and down, but it's also changing, for example, the motion inside of meld. And so whenever it gets intense, the colors are also getting intense because you can see saturation right here is one of those mappings. And so going back to the tree, a couple more things that I did was I used this shader right here to add this really weird shader called Boxinator. Pretty interesting. And then I used the bokeh blur to get more and more intense whenever it gets more intense. So we get this kind of blurring out effect. And this is the end result. Kind of weird, super psychedelic kind of thing, right? Okay, so check out this next example. Okay, so what on earth is happening here? Well, check this out. VideoSync comes with this device called VideoSimpler. And so normally in a drum rack, right, here's just a classic drum rack, 808, you have simplers living inside of each one of these cells, right? These are all just different cells. They have simplers in them. Sometimes they have other things in them, but for the most part, drum racks have simplers in them. What's so cool about VideoSync is they made a simpler, but instead it's for video. You can see that I can physically play these four different video clips that I have loaded into this drum rack, right? I can re-trigger them. And they have some crude controls such as start and loop and stuff like that, things that you're used to seeing inside of Simpler. But of course, instead of being audio, it's video. I think that this is really, really interesting because look how many cells a drum rack has, right? You got all these cells from all the way up to G8, all the way down to C-2. So that's 128 different positions for video clips to be in. And then if you think about the fact that you could save that drum rack, and that could be like one section of a show, you could put up to 128 drum racks inside of an instrument rack and use a chain selector. And essentially you could have more video clips than you could ever do for over a 2-hour show. And it would be right here inside of Ableton Live. And I think that's super interesting. Another thing I want to show you is this. I'm going to just take all of these devices, look at the CPU, I'm going to just delete them. Notice how the CPU didn't really change. I'll add them back in. Right? We're still hovering at 3%. What's going on there? Well, essentially, Ableton Live utilizes CPU, okay? That's what this is showing right here, okay? It's utilizing the CPU aspect of the computer. For the most part, the video processing happening in VideoSync uses the GPU, okay? So, especially with these new Silicon Macs, a lot of the GPU on the chip is just kind of sitting there unused. And so that's what's so awesome about this. It's kind of a marriage between these two technologies, allowing you to kind of make full use of your computer in an AV sense, right? So I think that's really interesting. But let's look at the next thing that I think is really interesting, and that's this pad right here. It sounds like this. So that's nice by itself, but what I did is I added a track where I've got this hummingbird, and this hummingbird is on another video simpler, but this time it's on slice mode. Notice that there's three different modes here, and so, of course, you know, if I'm playing this, I can kind of, I can play different positions of the wing beats, right? Right? Pretty cool, huh? So I decided to copy this little note rhythm. I muted this track because this is just being used for triggering stuff. I copied all these notes to make this rhythm, and I put it on this track, and I've just changed a bunch of the MIDI notes to get different wing positions. So let's go ahead and add the drums and the effects here. So yeah, that's how VideoSync can process actual video clips. Cool, so obviously there's no way that I could show every single aspect of VideoSync because there's so much more than I could go over in this video, but I just wanted to give you a quick overview of what you can do with it. I think it's really exciting. I think it's really great for folks who don't want to do stupid gimmicks on social media and instead want to continue to be creative and utilize skills that they already have in Ableton. If you like this kind of thing, like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see you next time.